Figure to all, and an angel, because of this man.
What have you done, Caleb? I did what you wanted. We had a deal.
What do you mean? I'm just doing what's right for the people. My people, not yours. Mine. Down with Lessons MP!
Here, we present to you Rise and Fall of Ben Jekyll.
City of sin. moment, the exit poll is suggesting a hung parliament with no clear overall winner. It's going to be a fascinating night, and doubtless one in which will be the most historic moments. Who can forget when Michael Portillo lost his seat in 1997, when Martin Bell was elected? We're looking forward to some historic moments, and it's over to Mike Hammersley in Barchester and Barchester constituency. I think, Mike, we have a declaration about to be made.
Yes, Andrew, we're expecting a declaration at any minute. And here in Barchester, the result of this historic night promises to be amongst the most remarkable of the evening. Rumour has it that the 20-year-old... Sorry, we're getting an announcement.
Ben, remember, whatever the result is, this isn't the end. We can always try again next year.
Way to go on the positivity.
I, Kiran Sharif, in the acting returning officer for the constituency of Barsetshire, do hereby announce the following results. Samuel Thomas Davison, 3,455. James Alexander Robertson, 14,967. Jordan Sweeney, 8,033.
Sound great.
Guys, your new SMP is about to depart. London calling.
Oh! He's had one too many. Besides, he seems pretty happy. I'm sure he'll come back and see his old friends.
Guys, it's 4:30 a.m. and I'm taking the first train up to London. So we have exactly 2 hours of partying to go. Come on, let's go.
Come on, Simon, let's go celebrate.
Yeah, let's go celebrate. So you earned it for the fame all along then?
I'm serious, Simon. I've never had so many people caring about me.
Oh, so I'm guessing 6 weeks of posters printing, door knocking, and helping you with your speeches was out of obligation?
Oh, come on, Simon. I know you all care, but you don't shove 20 cameras in my face every time I walk through a door. Look, I'm looking for an intern. Someone to start running the office in London. Take a team with you after it. Pretty good
I'm not so sure, Ben. I'm not even sure Steve is quite your city type.
Well, how are things back at home? Do you all miss me?
Yeah. Some of the guys are really broken up about it. Martin doesn't stop crying.
Don't worry, Ben. No one's really missed you.
Yeah, no one really liked you, to be honest.
Well, I'm going to come visit you guys soon. Or maybe you can come visit me. I think I texted you my address.
Yep, it's all here. Clapham. Ben, seriously, mate, whatever you do, don't become a hipster.
Only the best. And the rent was cheap because people think the place is haunted.
Oh, that sounds exciting. Who are you going to call?
Oh, sorry, Simon. I've got to go. Political stuff. I know, sounds thrilling. Okay, I've really got to go. I'll talk to you later. Bye.
Okay.
Yes.
Ben Jackman, I believe. You the alleged MP for Barchester and Barsetshire?
Sorry, do I know you?
Not yet. But we're definitely going to be much better acquainted over your time in. You see, amongst those in the know, I'm quite an important figure. And I do believe it's your way for a vote in the House. The best way, follow me, I know the bathroom. Mind you, I must ask what you're doing about this part of London when you should be able to vote in the House. No matter. In the size of your dress as well, about the back of white. Into the House, you can make that.
United Kingdom to have a much fairer deal when it comes to taxation.
Yes. I'm glad my honourable friend knows full well my commitment to fair taxation. The government has repeatedly cut taxes.
Yes.
Yes. While our deal for higher rate taxpayers is amongst the fairest in Europe.
Yes.
Mr. Goff.
I refer the Prime Minister to this morning's Telegraph and ask how the government will deal with the increasing problem of drug abuse among students.
I thank the Honourable Member for his question on such an important issue. Drug abuse is no trivial matter.
Yes.
And the government is committed to increase funding of 3.2
million
to improve drug counselling and education services.
Mr. Fairbrother.
Under the last government, rules surrounding gambling were relaxed, with the result that online gambling addiction is an increasing problem amongst our young. So I ask the Prime Minister to outline what he's going to address this problem.
Mr. Fairbrother, might I remind the Honourable Member that this is a forum for questions and not
yes. Yes.
Mr. Speaker, I refer the Honourable Member for Daventry to a recent report issued by the Home Office, and he will see how much the government is already committed to doing in this vitally important matter.
Yes.
Mr. Gerald.
Prime Minister, as a member of the Government of Edges, I have much to lose from asking inconvenient questions. And so, I must ask quite strongly, what is the government doing to alleviate the pressure of rent facing our young people? When will truly provide the so that young people can begin to afford their own homes and raise a family where they feel safe and don't face the threat of eviction or unaffordable rent prices?
Yes.
The government has committed £6.8 million
yes.
power.
I must press the Prime Minister on this matter. When there are millions of people stuck in substandard rent houses, I myself know of hundreds of 20-somethings in my own
constituency.
Yes. With no hope of buying. People who are working.
Yes.
House adjourned for 15 minutes.
You think he's worthy of all the attention he's getting?
You've done this theory, my dear. You'll learn.
Lucas. Jeffrey Winter. That's what I've heard of the corner of the house, so to speak. All kinds of dreadful mumblings in the tea room.
Tut tut, Caleb. Such gossip would be dreadfully embarrassing for an honourable member.
The High Whites won 47% of voters is one of life's little mysteries.
I learned to write the counter.
Don't be too vulgar, Anthony.
It's more like something more subtle and obvious. Perhaps a little interfering with the postal votes.
Could he have done that? Any dirt on him? Someone at Oxford must be able to unearth something about him.
The Master of Mark College. St. Mary's Hall has invited me to formal hall next week. It'd be interesting to hear what he has to say after a few glasses of port.
Don't be so vulgar. Do you honestly believe he was burning £50 loads in front of the homeless? He's more likely to have been arranging a rent strike in the name of fairness, for goodness sake. There's nothing more to this background than a few innocent indiscretions. These days, they're giving more votes than they lose you. They make you seem more human.
Either way, I don't like him.
Call it the interview. He has to be brought down a few pegs here and learn the ways of this house. People don't just walk in here and challenge our way of doing things. Goff, Fairbrother, Cartwright, how many years did you work for your seat? Am I the only one here who had to ingratiate myself with aldermen's tea parties to get myself here? He shows up after one campaign and everyone drools all over him like he's some sort of Mars bar in Lent.
Doesn't even know he's good. I know the extra friends at home might be speaking some promises for him. Not too much upstairs in bed, it seems.
Oh, Fairbrother, you're getting so wrong. He was given an exhibition at St. Mary's Hall at 17. A scientific genius at sea.
That's not hard. His parents probably drew money at the schools.
That's probably quite unlikely. It's a bit of bed, as far as I know.
Trust fund? Inheritance?
Again, he doesn't appear to have the most glamorous of backgrounds. So I doubt that also.
Well, I know.
All I know is he having made a few breakthroughs at Oxford. He was one of those annoying students who had balls to make suggestions for tutors.
Politically, he's naive. But there's a brain there. And he's got principles.
Good morning, gentlemen.
Well, we meet again. I like you, Ben. I think you're a good guy.
Well, thanks.
Well, we're supposed to be a little opposition, but you must really keep this quiet, yes?
Sure thing.
personal friends meeting up for a light-hearted card game. And there's a space opening for them.
Cards? What sort of cards?
Oh, nothing too difficult. Just a friendly game of poker with some convivial sort of chats. Decent wine.
Well, I guess it would be good to get to know some people. I'm not really the guy with Politico. I'm really starting to figure out a place here.
Well, great. You'll come to my humble abode at 11 o'clock this evening, then.
11 o'clock? Is that not quite late?
Ben, this is London, a city that never sleeps. You know, back in the 80s, lunch was for wimps. Today, it's still.
Okay, but...
What perfect timing.
June. Is he coming then? You know, I was really looking forward to meeting the youngest selected British MP in history.
I suppose I'll just ask him now, Adam.
Well, do you think you'll be able to make it?
Well, I guess I could, you know, pop by.
Great stuff.
Here, this is Jude's card. Text us if you'll be delayed. We'll be waiting for you, Ben.
And I almost forgot. There are a few house rules. Kind of like this place in a way. Bring cash. My friends like it when they can actually see what's on offer.
Well...
And the buy-in is £50, although it can increase depending on how the night progresses. So, get in quick.
£100. I thought you said it'd be 50.
Well, now it's 100. Is that okay with you, Nick?
Yeah, that's fine. Oh, now I see why you like it, didn't you?
Maybe it's quite finished mattering. Can we begin? Do you know what you're doing, Nick?
Yeah, I'm paid in uni.
La-di-da. Graves, don't go offending someone who actually has a reputation and an education. It only makes you appear denser than you already are.
Thank you.
He didn't answer! Again!
Maybe he's busy. Or just out.
Maybe, but he said he'd call me. I think you're thinking into this too much. He's really busy, you know.
It's 11 o'clock. He's not going to be working. Unless he's watching news night. Or on it.
Steve, I'm sure he'll be fine.
But what if he isn't? London's a big place.
Guys, he's a fully grown man. Not some rosy-cheeked toddler who's lost his mum at Tesco's.
I guess. Do you think I should go and see him?
Really, Simon? It's barely been 2 weeks. You just have to relax.
Well, I wanted to go and visit anyway. Now I have a reason.
Well, don't get ahead of yourself. The boss isn't just going to let you go gallivanting across Britain.
Well, that's nicely. Good old Dan is listening.
He's fine. We've worked for less than a week. Have you ever even met the guy?
Not yet. But when I do, we'll set it off like a house on fire.
Sure. Well, maybe he'll let you go in a few weeks, when things have quieted down a bit. But it's just not right to ask for a few days off a week into the job.
Fine. I'll go in a few weeks.
Well, if you're going, then so am I.
Great. It'll be like a mini holiday. I'm off to right now.
I'll walk on too.
Club off Charing Cross Road, beyond Leicester Square. I'll send you the address.
Ready for me to take more of your money?
Huh. Don't worry. I'll be getting it all back tonight. By the way, hire buy-in tonight. £1,000. Still good?
£1,000.
Should have mentioned it before. Higher stakes players are joining us.
Higher stakes?
Just a couple of friends. Keep it on the down low. They're the kind of people who wouldn't appreciate unwanted attention.
Okay. Sure. So is he even from Danny going to drop by?
Doubt it. Then again, the people coming tonight may pique his attention.
Ooh, exciting. See you tonight then.
Great. See you then, Nick.
His mind seems elsewhere. We haven't heard one of his rants for quite some time in the house.
Do we think the country is because of our one-hit wonder boy?
Someone should say something. He's not even paying attention.
It's like he doesn't care. He thinks he's indestructible.
What?
Oh! We were just sat here, working hard, representing our constituencies, and we happened to notice you not doing so.
Neglect of duty, Mr. Jekyll.
Care to explain why your personal needs are so much important than everybody else's?
How about you sit back down, stop worrying about me, and start worrying about my haircut. Sound good?
Mr. Jekyll, MP you may be, but you will not insult a man such as myself. Quite ungentlemanly to be texting in the house.
Thrown out for texting. I think I'll take my chances.
Fine. You go do that. Oh, Mr. Speaker, would you please tell Mr. Jekyll here to refrain from texting? I fear he may not be giving this important and insightful topic his full attention.
Mr. Speaker,
I'm only doing what's right.
Mr. Jekyll, please refrain from using your mobile off concession.
Yes.
Who's Nick anyway? Come, Mr. Jekyll, this is a place full of secrets. We all have our guilty pleasures, our little indiscretions, things that make life bearable.
Smalling, for once we're taken by the rules of the house, you must know it is the height, or perhaps pit, of poor manners to read over one's shoulder.
Thank you.
fit. I mean, they can't be enough space.
Speaking of people, where is them?
The address should be just over here. Call them address.
I didn't know how high profile meant. I mean, I'm pretty sure that guy's a footballer. And isn't that quite royalty?
Only a few acquaintances there. There's no problem. Our game will become famous now. We're one of the most acclaimed in London.
Great. But wasn't this meant to be just a friendly low-key event with a couple of friends?
Fine. It's all good. None of them know what you do, and most of them don't even know your name.
Hey, it just seems to be getting out of hand, that's all.
Word on the street is that Danny may be turning up if this all goes well. It could mean me. Stay calm. They respect you. All they want to do is place the cart in the world first. You don't have time for calls, Nick. Let it go. These are people with busy schedules. We have to get out.
Voicemail again. Maybe he's changed his number.
Well, we can ask him ourselves. I think this is the place.
Wow. It really is big, isn't it?
I know. There should be another door out the back.
This one doesn't look like it's been used very much.
Nick, we can be ready to deal. There's no point wasting time.
Time is money, Nick. Let's go.
Right. Well, I've spoken to a few of our newer guests, and the buy-in is now £10,000.
£10,000?
Then I guess you're not playing.
This is my game.
Actually, it's Nick's game, and I just bought you out.
There's a door just down here, just down the street, just inside Soho.
Well, we can let ourselves in, right? It's Ben. He knows us.
Cheat! Look at my cards, Nick. We're trying to pull here.
But you get your poor friend to cheat. We didn't tell you our cards.
What kind of scam is this?
Nick,
do something.
Hold on, let's look at Brad.
We want our money back.
Nick, you've got to keep the money.
Calm down, because you can save us.
Give us our money.
Dave. Simon, Steve, Martin.
Ben.
Ben, who the hell is Ben?
Nick.
Shit.
Mr. Carew!
Sir. Danny?
Sir Danny Carew!
Ben, you got his name!
Ben, wait! No, Nick!
Yeah.
Despite being on a peaceful stroll in the city streets in which he had devoted time and money into cleaning up.
Despite the infinite love of the people he had saved.
Despite this. Beloved,
Sir Danvers Carew has been found murdered.
Your help. I've done something wrong. Please.
Forget it, Ben. You've forgot me and Martin and Steve and Tom.
I know what you did. What are you talking about? Who is this?
Who I am does not matter. What matters is who I am.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I think you know exactly what
I'm
talking about.
Who is this?
Now, you're going to follow some instructions. And your precious secret will remain as such.
Who is this?
Do we have a deal?
How did you get this number?
I believe you're focusing too much on the unnecessary. As for the matters, I am here to explain myself.
What do you know?
You know exactly what I know, Ben. Or is it Nick?
Mr. Jekyll is missing once again from important matters.
It's been almost 2 weeks since he's been seen here. The chief whip is livid.
Anthony, you do jump to conclusions too quickly. But, we're learning.
Prime Minister, if I might.
Oh, Caleb, it's been a long time since we've spoken.
Sometimes, Prime Minister, the old guard has much to offer.
Meaning?
Lewis can explain, yes. Ben Jekyll, such a promising young MP, seems to be in a spot of bother. It's all great sooner or later in the press. It's all over Twitter and the blogosphere. As soon as the lawyers at the BBC have their hands on it, it's going to be his end.
Do you know, Mr. Goff, I think I want to end this conversation.
Mr. Prime Minister, what is it about Ben Jekyll?
Gentlemen, I have a business I must attend to urgently.
Excuse me too.
I'm trying to get hold of some of Danny's old stuff. Please, I need help. I'm desperate.
Nick, Ben, which is it today? We're still looking for some money.
Well, you can still write up behind my little son as well.
Jude, please, I'm sick. I need help. It has to be him. I can't think of anyone else who would do it.
What? You stole Danny's goods. Release something in you. Most people have the time of their lives, but you turn nasty and violent and wouldn't stop. Learn to take some responsibility. You're a man, Ben.
It all makes sense now. He obviously doesn't like me and has a way to turn everyone against me. It's Caleb's ruling.
You really think that this Taylor fellow will blackmail? Why would he do that?
I don't know. I'm guessing if I'm out of his way, and he's the one to find Harry's killer, he'll be a hero. He'll be in the press, champion of the people, a return to old-fashioned values.
Taylor is not an old-fashioned, failed politician. He'll be on the backbenches of their careers for the rest of their lives. He might even end up with a knighthood for loyal services to the party. Sir Caleb Smallwood. Certain ring to it, don't you think? Pillar of establishment.
Exactly my point. No one thinks of Caleb and his lot as anything but another bunch of spineless politicians. But if he's the one to find the murderer of our nation's beloved Karen, he'll be the saviour of our country.
What's he asking for now?
At the moment, he just wants me to keep my head down.
So he can get some more power?
I don't know. I'm guessing he'll ask for money, and after the incident earlier, I'm fresh out.
Most of us carry at least two cell phones, then. Anonymous web browsers and all that. Someone of your age must understand. Now, I have an appointment. A reputation to restore in my customers. And the smell of this place is making me nauseous. So glad I turned off my GPS and my phone when I got near this part of town. Just a certain precaution I've always taken. Just keep things hidden.
This will be me, the irritating paper guy. So, can you help me?
I think I may be of some use.
Finally! Who was it?
Not really sure how this information's relevant to me.
It could be important. I've got a bad feeling.
That sounds nice and ominous. I think we need to talk.
A murderer to lead them and represent them in Parliament.
This is no honourable member we're talking about here. This is a man lacking in all honour.
Traitor!
Why should we trust him? Why should he sleep peacefully among us when you, the British public, lie awake? We deserve to see this man locked up. We lost a great man because of his evil. We lost a hero, a father figure to all, and an angel because of this man.
What have you done, Caleb? I did what you wanted. We had a deal.
What do you mean? I'm just doing what's right for the people. My people, not yours, mine. Damn, let's attend pay!
Ben, stop! Please, get off him! It was June!
We should all try again.